What does a QA engineer actually do? Let's talk about it. Hey, what's up, guys? This is Caleb King. I'm a software engineer. Now look, we all hate when we download an app, use a website, use any type of tech, and it's buggy. And it's really annoying when you, as the end user, finds the bugs. When you're the one going to the iOS store, leaving a review, pretty much telling them, this app is horrible. It's so buggy. The camera doesn't work. It doesn't load. It crashes. All of those things are all part of quality. And there's actually dedicated teams called quality assurance teams. So that's what we're going to be talking about. Who are QA engineers? What they do, what is the role of quality assurance, and everything in between. Which leads me into our sponsor for this video, me. So I've been working on a book called Level Up Programming, and it's the ultimate developer guide. So if you want to make your career as a software developer more successful, then this book will be for you. It's not just written from my perspective. I've actually done the research and reached out to 50 different industry experts within IT to not only share their tips and tricks, but give you all the secrets that you need to not only level up your career, whether you're a junior, mid-level, senior, or maybe you just want to establish yourself as an authority within tech. So the first 50 people who sign up at books.peopleintech.io will get 25% off the book when it releases later on this year. And it's going to come in audio format and written format. So again, books.peopleintech.io. Join the waiting list so you can get the book the second it drops. So with the rise in tech jobs, more people are looking at becoming QA analysts, QA engineers. But before you take the plunge and set off on a career path, you might want to do some research on exactly what is a QA engineer, what do they do? In the grand scheme of things, a QA engineer is somebody who's curious about how technology works. They enjoy delving into the nitty-gritty, and they're really natural problem solvers. So the job requires a lot of time, a lot of planning, how to best test computer software, how to solve problems, how to identify problems, how to think outside the box. Becoming a QA engineer might be right for you if you're a stickler for detail, you aren't afraid to critique other people's work, you have strong communication skills, you have an interest in technology, and you love to solve problems. But let's start off by answering the question, what is QA? Quality assurance. Quality assurance is a system of testing which guarantees that the customer is given high quality software that's free of critical errors. QA engineers dream of releasing a piece of software that is completely bug free. However, they are the fact of life in software and development. Their goal, like the development team, is to release the highest quality product ever. And every software company in the world, from big tech giants to startups, use QA. What does a QA engineer do? It's a good question, and you might like the answer. They break things. They break things on purpose so the customer doesn't break them on accident. However, don't get it twisted. A QA engineer, they're not breaking things recklessly. Quality assurance testing is a methodical approach. It's a process that requires planning, careful execution, and documentation. QA engineers are usually the first ones to encounter anything that might make a user experience worse. So after testing a software, a QA engineer would document any problems they had and send a report to the development team who revises the software. And the cycle of development and testing continues until a QA engineer, or maybe a team of QA engineers, are satisfied with the final product and give their stamp of approval once the QA engineer signs off saying, this is ready for release. You might be asking, what do QAs actually test though? They test everything. As a web app developer, as a mobile app developer, they're testing login. If you have an e-commerce store, they're making sure you can add things to the cart. You can check out, you can go back, you can add things again, you can remove things from the cart. They're making sure every piece of the workflow, everything that's intentional for what we're trying to build, works seamlessly. I can't tell you how many times the QA has actually saved my butt, because a lot of engineers, like I said before, like Kodak Black says it, we tunnel vision. We look at it one way, we only build one way, we only think one way sometimes. And a QA engineer is the one who's double checking if everything works as intended. You might be asking, how does QA actually test code? And it's a good question. Back in the day, everything was manual. Nowadays, a lot of the testing is done with automation tooling. things like Selenium, Cypress, WebDriver. These are tools where QA engineer will write code that tests the same features over and over. And it gives somebody like myself confidence that anytime I introduce something new, whether it's a new feature like login, searching for a product, adding a product, changing the quantity of the product, anything related to the application itself, I can now hit a button and ensure that everything before still works and anything new moving forward also works. And don't get me wrong, manual testing is still there, but just the value of it has changed because as applications get larger, it's harder to hire more people to do manual testing, but occasionally spot checking from time to time is still valuable. And finally, let's talk about money. The salary range of a QA engineer goes from $26,000 to $150,000. And what I like about QA engineering is you can land a job at a startup or a tech company. You can do contract work, which is one of the best side hustles. Once you learn Selenium, Cypress, any of these automation tool suites, some organizations will bring on an entire QA team to make sure their app works. Other companies like startups, they can't afford a QA engineer or a QA team. So what they do, they're outsourced. But that's where you can actually have a phenomenal side hustle, lucrative contract. I've seen people get QA contract for startups for like $50,000 and it was like 2 weeks worth of work. So we all understand that QA is valuable. It's just some companies can dedicate a whole team to it, or other companies just need to have some automation tests in place and then they're supplemented with maybe one or two manual testers. But the sky's the limit. The average is around $75,000 in terms of salary range. But like I said, if you work at certain tech companies, I've seen people get up to $200,000 running a whole QA department. And I've seen some people do some side hustling with QA. Because when I see $26,000, don't get me wrong, those people are usually manual testers, but even that can be lucrative depending on how much manual testing you're doing. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and we're working on a how to become a in tech series. So if you liked everything we broke down in this one, stay tuned for that series dropping out pretty soon. And I'm also trying something new, so don't judge me too hard. Tech out. That was it. Instead of me saying like peace, tech out. All right, you guys get it. I'll see you later.